We're a diversified farming operation. We have row crops, field crops, permanent crops, walnuts, prunes, oranges, wine grapes, and row crops we have processing tomatoes. Part of the reason I'm still getting satisfaction and enjoyment out of doing it is because we're always changing things, trying to improve, and that's the what I enjoy in my relationship with the University of California, because we do a lot of projects with them, with the researchers, and we're always trying to improve and try new things, and that keeps it interesting. If I was doing the same thing every year that I did 40 years ago, 40 years of them, I probably wouldn't be as enthused about farming right now.
For growers, making a planting decision at the beginning of the year, they have to be confident that they can produce that crop because they're going to make a sizable investment in each acre. Well, the confidence that that grower has in being able to diagnose diseases, being able to irrigate that crop properly and efficiently, being able to control weeds or manage other pests, all comes back to technology, and the basis for that technology for processing tomato has been on this UC Davis campus.
So what we'd like to do with our basic science knowledge that we've gained by studying tomatoes is to help growers to have a better product that they can deliver to producers, processors, and the public for their consumption of more healthy, more flavorful tomatoes. I get up in the morning because I'm excited about research. I'm excited about understanding how processes work in plants. I'd like to use my basic science information to improve the quality of a product that we can produce here in California, that the university can provide to growers for the industries and agriculture in California.
With the challenges that face agriculture in California, we've got to be on the cutting edge, and we've got to be super efficient. And if we're going to stay a viable industry in California, we're going to need all that help that we can get.